As we have seen, a compass indicates the direction of magnet poles by detecting the Earth's magnetic field. The Earth's magnetic field is a vertical element, as well as a horizontal element, as depicted in the diagram. The nearer the magnet pole, the magnetic component becomes, and the less the horizontal component becomes. Eventually, at the pole, the vertical element becomes 90 degrees, due to magnetic pole being directly below the position. The angle that magnetic lines form make to horizontal, referred to as the angle of dip. This angle will be maximum at the magnetic poles, and reduce as we move away from the pole. Approximately halfway between the magnetic pole, the angle will be zero, as the component is horizontal, and the vertical element is null. Position where it occurs is at the magnetic equator. It is difficult for system to instruct the vertical element Earth's magnetic field, as this induces errors. The horizontal element is to determine magnetic north, and this is known as direct force. As is seen in the diagram, angle dip will vary with increasing magnitude. Example is a dip angle, as it's in the magnetic equator. Example B, more dip at mid-latitudes, although the angle is acceptable. Example C has a large angle dip, as it is near to the magnetic pole. The angle dip is referred to as inclination, and the line of zero dip, magnetic equator, is referred to as an acyclic line. The magneticists generally use a method of pendulous suspension that ensures that the magnetic detector is as horizontal as possible, and is therefore more effective in sensing the horizontal component. This is discussed in more detail later.